This has seen young people design various artwork, where 680 youth participated, of which 216 are girls. The project was launched on the World Refugee Day this year to ensure the young people can exercise their skills for resilience and self-support. Some of the refugees who benefited share their experience after attaining the training.
It has changed in our group. Now we are earning a lot of profit out of it. That's why we can be able to get these things to design the earring. We were not having these beads, but the profit that we have earned out of it, we are now unable to buy these beads, and we design our plastic with the beads. It adds on our interest. It has solved my problem.
Via the strategy that I use, I do save from where I work in order to buy what I needed. Otherwise, I will need a support from any other side that can best help me out to start my own. As part of what I can do for myself, like things to do with clothing, I don't longer any of my relative or father to buy for me.
Emmanuel Sechito, the executive director of Faces Up Uganda, that has been organizing the youth in the artwork display, discovered that girls do not participate much in technical and skills training, but the EU Trust Fund has come in to enroll more girls to join skills training.
Most of these sectors have been named or termed for the boys, for the guys, and the girls somehow don't actively participate in this. But for us, this does not show that the girls are not participating, but we are seeing the girls standing up and taking up the spaces.
Since 2006, EU has committed over $400 million in life-saving humanitarian assistance to support the refugees and host communities in Uganda. Rosine Carlos, the program manager, Refugee Response, European Union, Uganda, says the participants, mostly young children and youth, participated in the art craft work to design various aspects of life, environment, and other physical components to display their skills in artwork.
We all recognize that this policy is incredibly progressive and really setting the scene as a world leader in refugee response. And this is, of course, how Uganda will be introduced on the stage at the Global Refugee Forum next month. Working together with the government and with our implementing partners in refugee hosting districts. And in all cases, everything we do is always to support both the refugee communities and the host communities, of course. We've talked a little bit about this already, but some of these actions have included support to skilling and livelihoods, to equip refugees with resilience, with the tools they need. And we can see some examples of that here at the exhibition. So I please encourage you all to visit and to speak to some of our beneficiaries who are here today. Additionally, we've had support to services, including local governance, education, water and sanitation. And this is done across West Nile, but also in the southwest of Uganda.
Skilling is a very important goal of the NLM government, because it provides the clearest solution to the most challenging issues of the youth unemployment.
The EU Trust funding has seen a handful of refugees and host communities move away from handouts but work out alternative ways of living amidst the food reduction and categorization of food for refugees. Report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news in Yumbe District.